Your friend Harsh here, and in this video we are gonna install Neovide on Windows. So the first thing we are gonna do is make sure that we have Neovim installed, because Neovide is not a standalone software. In the sense, it requires a Neovim install as its base. Understand that Neovide is just a client that runs on top of Neovim. Go to the repository and get the repository link from there, because we are going to clone it to our system. Now, why do we need to clone it? Why not just get the exe file? Well, if you use some third-party package managers like Chocolate or Scoop, chances are that it might not work on your system. And since it didn't work for me, I'm going to suggest you to build it from source, alright? Now, where you clone it is also an important factor. So make sure you are going to clone it on a permanent location on your system, just like you would do for any other app. I have selected C tools for my case, because whenever I install any developer dependency like Python or Node.js, I do it in there. Now that I have cloned it, I'm going to head over to the documentations in the repository itself. So it's there in the README, the build instructions for Windows. You can follow along the build instructions, it works. But I'm going to demonstrate it for you, because that's the point of this video. Now you need three things first. Rust can be installed like so. You can go to the website and download the exe file and then run it. It will open up a command prompt. Just select the default installation procedure and continue. After it gets installed, install the other dependencies that are LLVM and CMake. In order to do that, we are gonna get a package manager called Chocolate. You can also use Scoop, but I always go for Chocolate. So to install it on your system, you need to go to the Chocolate website and copy this link. Now this is a magical link, because if you run it on your PowerShell in administrator mode, it will install Chocolate directly. So after it's installed, we are going to proceed and get CMake and LLVM using the commands given in the documentation itself. Because there is a specific version that is required, so it's always better to follow the documentation. After having installed both, we are going to go ahead into our Neovide directory that we cloned. Run the simple command cargo build release. That means we are trying to build the version of Neovide which is tagged as the release version. So it has minimum bugs, no newer features, because again, Neovide is a product in the making, it will have bugs, and it's always good to have the latest release so that any new bugs that are found are resolved. Now we just need to wait out through the entire build process, and mind you, this won't happen each and every time. That is, all these dependencies that you are seeing getting downloaded and installed, this will only happen once. The next time you update it, you will have to git pull to get the latest changes from the repository, and then just cargo build release again. And all the dependencies are already stored on your PC, so you don't need to worry about them. Now that we sat out through the entire build process, we end up at the last final build, that is the Neovide bin file. Now that the build is done, we are gonna navigate to the target release folder, and here we have the Neovide exe. So now it's done, you can just open it and Neovide runs successfully, and it uses the same dot files that you use on Neovim by default, but you won't find any animations other than the cursor animations, because Neovide has to be launched with the flag called multigrid in order for the other animations to appear, like the window pane animations and the scrolling animations. Thanks for watching guys, and see you in the next one.